Hey everybody, how's it going? Hope you're having a good day. This is Ryan with Wolf Woodworking. In this video, I'm going to make a charcuterie board. My friend reached out. Her church is having a fundraiser and wanted me to make something for the silent auction. And charcuterie boards are quite popular right now, so I figured that would probably be best and can hopefully get them the most money for what I can offer for them. This will be a walnut charcuterie board. So this is a 48 inch piece of walnut. I'm gonna rip it right in half. Cut it right in half to make it just as wide. And then I will, just to make it, give it a little flair, give it a little character, I'm gonna run a piece of maple through it to kind of break up the dark color of the walnut, which I always think looks really nice. So we'll go over that process of, I'm going to joint these strips and then glue them together. This piece of walnut, or excuse me, the piece of maple is a little thicker than the walnut, so I'll plane all the boards down to the exact same size so when they glue up, they're nice and even. And then we'll sand that down, install the handles, and then oil it. It's pretty straightforward, but there is some work to do with the jointing and planing. You want to make sure everything is precise when it's glued up. You don't want any gaps or anything like that. So it's kind of like an end grain cutting board, just on a smaller scale. Let's get started. So for this part, I fed this piece through, and as you can see, it stops right there and gets stuck. I gently try to pull it out, but obviously I don't want to force anything, so I shut it off, wait for the blades to stop, and see what's going on. It's still jammed in there, so what I do is I'll go up and release the lock valve and raise the planer up, and I found out that there was a angle to the wood where I was feeding it the small end, and the wood actually got increasingly bigger, so it got jammed in the planer. So to fix this, I just raised the planer up to the thickest side of the board and start slowly feeding it through until the wood then gets leveled to the spot that got jammed. So now that that issue is taken care of, I'll run all the boards through to be the same thickness. Alright, so everything's been planed, jointed, cut to size. These are 2 foot boards. So now all that's left to do is just glue up. I checked all the joints, they seem airtight. So what I'll do is, I have my cabinet clamps here. To me, these do the best job gluing up because they don't bow the boards when you put pressure on them. And when you're doing glue ups, obviously that's the most ideal situation, is you do not want any bowing or cupping in your boards when you start putting pressure on them. I know pipe clamps work great, but I found that they tend to have a little bit of bone them. You can kind of counter it by putting clamps on top as well, but to me, if you're going to do a lot of cutting boards or projects where you can use these clamps, I would recommend it. They just work best in my opinion. So what we'll do is get this glue on here. I've said this before, these condiment dispensers work really great for gluing up. The ease of use with the squeezing of the glue out is much easier than kind of the cap that comes with the glue bottle, and it keeps really well too. Another tip I've mentioned is take the time to spread the glue out across the board here. The pressure from the clamp is not enough to spread the glue across the boards. You do need to, there's applicators, things like that. If you're not comfortable getting the glue on your fingers, you know, to each their own, whatever works best for you. I don't care, so I just use my finger. Some people don't like that, so we get the applicator. So go ahead and, of course, make sure you have paper towels on standby. So what I'll do is I'll just, this board's gonna go in the middle, so I'll lay that one down here, put the maple stripe there, get this pretty well lined up. So I'll cut the ends off, but I obviously don't want to take too much of the walnut if I don't need to. You can kind of scoot them back and forth like this to get the wood in there. I know that helps. And another method I'm going to do is, this just helps keep the boards level when you're gluing them up. You can see there's a little dip there, nothing too crazy, but it's always nice just to put a little clamp on. Make sure you put tape on your clamps like this, so when you are done, the glue doesn't stick to the clamps, and then you have clamps stuck to your boards. Never good. In that case, you might be starting over. So take a second, put some clamps on there. Right now, I'm just putting enough pressure. They're just enough pressure just so they're sitting on there, because I need to clamp them together first before I tighten those down. That will be the last thing. I'll kind of do it in conjunction with each other so they're both getting equal pressure. So same thing, this side. Again, just enough pressure to get them on there. Not doing any tightening yet. Everybody. Okay, so there we go. So just enough to get on there. Push these up against there. Let's get some starting pressure. Nothing too crazy. So now I have a little pressure on these. I am going to go ahead and tighten these up a little bit just to get that even pressure going. So now that those are even there a little bit, I'll apply the pressure. And I've mentioned this before, when you're gluing up boards, you don't got to go incredible hulk on these things. You know, you want just enough pressure to keep the boards together. If you tighten them too tight, you can crack the wood, bow it, all the bad stuff. So just get enough to where you know that it's not going to move. You can see I'm not, I mean, you can use your fingers. That's how much pressure I'm putting. It's not, you know, anything crazy. And you want to double check though, with these cabinet clamps, sometimes you can feel like you're tightening and it's, the clamp is tightening to the metal, not to the metal brace, but not to the wood. So just double check, just do a little pressure here. Let me see that one. See, that's moving a little bit. So I'll loosen it up, use my hand to keep the clamp against the wood. Get a little tightened on there, that should do it. Yep, so now we're good. Same thing on this side. You see it's moving a little bit. Do the same thing. Go. Check, make sure you're good. I have one clamp in the middle. Two clamps, one third and about two thirds of the way in would have been probably fine, but I have tons of clamps and I don't mind using them. So another thing I mentioned, I won't show in this process, but in about 10 or 15 minutes after glue up, you can see the squeeze out. I like to leave it. If you wipe it right now, you might be a master at it and you can wipe it without it spreading. I like for it to dry a little bit till it gets almost like a gummy it's more solid than liquid at that point. And then you can take a chisel or whatever you have and just scrape it off. And that way the glue comes up, but it doesn't spread the glue on the wood. And when you're doing, especially doing cutting boards, and you have, if you do an end grain and you have multiple strips with a ton of glue, that saves you a ton of time in the end with sanding and all that stuff. So this will work fine. We'll come back in a little bit and scrape the glue off. Okay, cool. So I did a couple of other steps from the last segment. I cut the sides off and cut it to size, sanded that, and then I went ahead and took my router bit and just did the straight edge on the side here to give it that nice kind of, I like that look of having a routed edge. Shows the wood detail a little bit more, and it just looks nice and just a square, just plain side, give it a little bit more character. So I did a 120 grit sanding on this, and then I sprayed it. Like any charcuterie or cutting board, butcher block, anything with food on it, I like to do is you spray the wood and erase the grain, then you sand it down for a closer finish. I did that probably two or three times. I'll probably go to 150 and then 220 grit sandpaper and finish there, and then we'll oil the board. We'll actually put the handles on, and then we'll oil the board. So I'll come back when I'm done sanding to put the handles on. Okay, so we have our finished board here. I took it down to a 220 grit, which left me with the finish I was looking for. Very smooth and ready to be oiled and have the handles installed. So for the handle installation process, I'm going to use this, it's more of like a cabinet handle jig, but it'll be the same thing for these. It'll work just fine. I'm using these kind of brass type of, kind of like a dark brown, kind of like a copper look to them that to me go with the walnut very nicely. And then we'll oil it and it'll be all finished. So I'll bring the camera in a little closer for the handle installation process so you can see it a little better. Okay, so we have our board here ready for the handle installation. I put blue tape under the board where the drill will come out. That should help eliminate some blowout. And I'm also drilling into a board, which will, it really should eliminate all the blowout altogether. Give us a nice clean drill out. You certainly want it to look its best. I also found the center of the board here and transferred the dot down pretty far on the board for this reason of, I have my jig set to where I want the handles placed, and I have the width of the handle set as well for the drill marks. So when we bring this on, there's a center position on the jig that you line up then with your center mark. So we have our zero lined up with the center mark on the board, so we know we're in the middle. So I have a 5/32 bit on here for these screws, so it should go right through. So we can go ahead and drill our first hole. Business. We'll see how the back look. Okay, yep, so we have a nice clean exit there, which is what you're looking for. So I'll go ahead and speed this up and do that to the other side. Okay, so now that that is done, what I like to do is flip this over. I'll leave the blue tape on as well, but I have this other one loaded, ready to go. It's a countersink bit. When you put the screws in, you can see here, you don't want the screws sitting on top of the board. It just looks sloppy and it'll make the board uneven, and it's just not a good practice. So take your, you can either get a, I just use this, I have it loaded, ready to go, or there's drill bits that have the countersink already built in, but this works fine for me. When you pull it up there, you have nice clean holes, which is always preferred. Okay, give me 1 second. I'm gonna speed this up and I'll vacuum this up real quick. Okay, so now we can go ahead and install
the handles. So the screws will go in through the bottom here. Okay. Do that. Push that in a little bit. Do a little hand screw just to get the screw in. Bring it to the other side. You can use a screwdriver. I like to use my drill. I'll just put it on the lowest setting. You don't want to ram it in there. It could crack the wood, break the handle, all that bad stuff. So just take it, kind of ease it in there. No rush. Good. I'll speed it up and do it to the other side as well. Okay, perfect. So the handles are installed. All we need to do now is oil up the board. Okay, one suggestion I'll make for oiling up boards is make sure you're doing it at a time or a day where, if you're gonna leave this in your workshop area where you're working, make sure you're not doing much of anything with sanding or cutting or anything that's going to kick up any dust, because you don't want the sawdust to sit in the oils and all that stuff. So all right, so that is oiled up and ready to go. We will leave it. You can probably see I gave a very generous amount of oil on this board, which is fine. I'd rather over oil, and when after a half hour or so, whatever oil is left, you can wipe it off certainly, and because the board will more than likely soak it in. So we'll leave it. I'll leave it on its handles so that way the whole board can be exposed to the air and let the wood do its thing. But you can see it came out absolutely beautiful. That 220 grit, as I mentioned before, leaves such a beautiful shine on the wood, and the oil just really amplifies how incredibly beautiful walnut maple is to work with. But so this is finished, and we will give it to the client for the charity auction, and hopefully brings in some good money for a good cause. As always, I hope you have a great day. I hope this video helped, and let me know if I have any questions. Happy to answer them for you. Have a great day, everybody.